The question says the two plates of a capacitor of capacitance C have charges plus QO and plus 2QO as shown. Now plates A and B are connected to positive and negative terminals of the battery of potential difference V is equals 2QO by C. Then work done by the battery to establish the potential difference V across the plates A and B is. And we are having four options. We have to choose any one which is correct. And here is the corresponding picture. There are two plates A and B with initial charges QO and 2QO. Right? QO and 2QO. Two keys are provided on either side of the plates. And here is a battery of constant potential difference V, which is equal to 2QO divided by C. C is the capacitance of this capacitor, right? C is the capacitance of this capacitor. Now, what we have to find is, we have to find the amount of work done by the battery. Okay, amount of work done by the battery. Now, when the battery is connected to the capacitor, the work done by the battery, see, the work done by the battery, work done by the battery is W is equals Q into delta V. Otherwise, we can write delta Q into V, whatever it is. Here, what actually this delta Q is? Amount of energy transferred at constant potential difference. Now, this will help us. Okay. So, delta Q is amount of charge transferred. Okay. Amount of charge transferred. Transferred at constant potential difference. At constant potential difference V. Okay. So, this is the clue which will help us in order to find the final answer. Now, what I do is, I first assume the two keys are pressed. Okay, that means battery is connected to the two plates of the capacitor. So, let us do that. Now, I am having the two plates of the capacitor like this, right? One is the plate A and another one is plate B. Okay, so the battery is then connected, right? Battery is then connected like this. What is the potential difference of the battery? It is 2QO divided by C. This is given. The capacitance of the capacitor is at C. Now we shall work out. So when the capacitor is fully charged, when the capacitor is fully charged, the amount of charge, amount of charge on plates A and B are, say, it is a Q dash and a minus Q dash. Therefore, what I can do is, any one plate I think, that is C is equals what I can write? It is Q dash divided by V. This is the potential difference of the battery up to which the capacitor is charged. Further, what I can do? I can simply do calculation for Q dash, that is C into V. And Q dash is equal to what? It is C multiplied by V. So, V is what? It is 2QO divided by C, which is given here. Right. So, definitely the terms C get cancelled. And what I left with? I left with Q dash is equals 2QO. Right. Q dash is equals 2QO. What is the meaning of this? That means the inner plate of A is having a charge plus 2QO, and the inner plate of B here, right, it is minus 2QO. So plus 2QO on plate A inside, minus 2QO on plate B inside, right? So let it be. So then what we can, there may not be any charges on outside, okay? So let's say it's 0 and 0, let it be. So now what I have to think is, right, so I have to calculate the amount of charge the transferred. Why? Because initially the capacitor was not empty. There are some charges on the two plates before connecting the battery, right? So QO here and 2QO here. Let us think about the effective charges on the two plates. Let me do that work now. See, this is a plate A, and here is a plate B. Okay, this is plate B. How much charge is here? It is QO, and on this it is 2QO. Right, so it is 2QO and QO here. Both are plus, right? So this is also plus, and this also plus. Now we have to think how much charges are there inside. One thing you must know, the amount of charge inside, say it is Q in, this should be positive, and minus Q in here. That means the inner faces should possess equal and opposite charges. This is the hint. As well as the outside also possess the equal amount of charge. That is, say Q out here and Q out here. Okay. So let me take some different names, and later I may show you Q out here and Q out dash here are same. Okay. So let me do that. First, there is a hint for you. For this, I use a technique called differential charges. Okay, so I use differential charges. Differential charges. That means Q in. Okay, so this one Q in on A. Okay, plate A. So that is equal to what I have to do. I have to do like this, you know. Plus QO on a plate A minus plus 2QO on the plate B whole divided by 2. We have to consider the signs like this, and the two charges must be subtracted. That means Q in is equal to what I get. So this is equals QO, right, minus 2QO divided by 2. That means Q in must be is equals what? It is minus QO divided by 2. That means the charge inside is minus QO divided by 2. Yeah. Okay. So, and this must be plus QO. So that I may write here, right? So it is minus QO divided by 2, and it is capital QO, right? So otherwise I rewrite it. Capital letter QO divided by 2, and here it must be plus capital letter QO divided by 2, right? So this is equal to this much, is equal to this much. Okay, so now you can do work, how much amount of charge are there outside. There is no need of doing that calculation, but I simply show you what happens actually. Do this kind of work. That is, say here, Q out plus this one must be is equals QO. Okay, so Q out plus minus QO divided by 2 must be is equals plus Q. What I can write now? So it is Q out minus Q divided by 2 is equals Q. Otherwise, Q out is equals Q plus Q by 2. Right. So further, it will be Q out is equals 3Q divided by 2. So this is the charge, amount of charge 3Q by 2 that stays outside plate A here. Okay. So it is plus 3Q by 2. Okay. This is the amount of charge that is lying outside of plate A. So let us think what is Q out dash. Okay. So here what I have to do is Q out dash plus this must be is equals this. Okay. So that is Q out dash plus of a plus Q by 2. Right. Q by 2 must be is equals plus 2 Q. Okay. So just to avoid some confusion, I am using this technique. No need of doing like this complication. Plus Q divided by 2. So which is equals 2 Q. Right. So Q out dash is equal to what I can do. It is 2 Q minus Q divided by 2. Otherwise Q out dash is equals. It will be 4 minus 1. It is 3 and divided by 2 Q. So what we are seeing, Q out is equal to Q out dash, right? So again, the amount of charge which is here is plus 3 Q O divided by 2. So that means the exterior of A and exterior of B are possessing same amount of charges. Okay, leave. So put your concentration here in between the plates. The inner plate of A is possessing minus Q by 2 at the in the beginning. Okay. So it is the beginning charge. So I will write it here. The inner side of A. Okay. In the beginning. How much charge it is possessing? It is minus Q divided by. At the end, that means when you connect the battery, so how much charge is there inside plate A? It is plus 2 QO, right? So plus 2 QO. Plus 2 QO. Now see, in the beginning, this much charge was there inside plate A. And at the end, we are having this much charge inside the plate A. So from this, what we can do is I can simply calculate delta Q. This is the amount of charge that transferred from plate A. Okay. So that is equal to how much? At the end, we are having this one, which is plus 2 Q minus. At the beginning, it is minus Q divided by 2. So that is delta Q is equal to what I can do. It is 2 Q plus Q divided by 2, it will be 5 Q divided by 2. And now work done is equal to what the formula? It is delta Q into V. So this is equal to 5 Q divided by 2 into what I should write? I should write 2 Q divided by C. So terms 2 to get cancelled. So this will be is equals 5 Q O square divided by C. This is the amount of work done by the battery to establish a potential difference V. 5 Q O square divided by C. 5 Q O square divided by C is here. This is the answer for this question.